It is your boy, the coach, you're live on the coach's show, the coach's show live. Okay, boy, Robert is at it again, old Robert Aaron. He's at it again. So basically, he just pretty much, he put it out there. And he said that, you know, Devin Haney got to do something. He got to show me something in order for him to fight Teofimo Lopez. All right, so I hear a lot of people always say, you know what, I can't wait to Bob Arum retire, you know. I can't wait to Bob Arum do this. And I'm not going to say what everybody else say. I'm not going to say that because, you know, hey, you know, Bob Arum done been around the game for a while. I'll just say, you know, people can't wait for Bob Arum to retire. Now, you know, that's okay, cool. I mean, in your world, that's going to be a good thing. But it's just going to be somebody else that pop up to block these fights. That's all. Okay, see, let me tell you about these promoters. They're all the same people. They really are the same people. They just have different ways of going about blocking fights or, you know, price gouging fans. That's just what it is, okay? They're going to try to milk this fight for all it's worth. And you would think during the pandemic, you would think that boxing would actually learn a lesson, you know? But it just seemed like boxing don't really learn its lesson. But boxing will never truly learn that lesson because the fans are going to allow, you know, Teofimo Lopez to fight a mandatory, which... You know, we all know that the mandatory that he's going to have to fight is not even competitive. Okay, it won't be a competitive matchup. You know, I think that, you know, boxing, we got to get out of the habit of, you know, just waiting and waiting. And I think that we got to strike while this fight is hot now. You know, while these two guys in their prime, while they trash talking. Because, you know, maybe you can get a trilogy out of this, you know? I mean, I don't know. I just know that the way Bob Arum was talking, this fight... I mean, guys, we probably won't see this fight until 5 years down the line. I'm just telling y'all. I mean, I think personally, you know, we need to see this fight, you know, at least at the end of 2021, okay? I mean, at the end of 2021, Teofimo Lopez, Devin Haney. Oh, you know what? I don't even care. I'd even take Teofimo Lopez and Tank Davis. I mean, I don't care. I'd take either of the two. Just give us something, okay? Just give us something to look forward to. You know, I mean, it's not hard to make these fights. You know, Bob Arum said, I'm not going to put my person in a fight that I don't think he can win. Well, I mean, that pretty much kind of tells you the whole story. It tells you the whole shebang. Okay? Maybe Bob Arum don't think Teofimo Lopez can beat Devin Haney. Okay? Maybe he don't think he can beat Tank Davis. Because, you know, I don't hear Bob Arum talking about Tank Davis either. And you would think out of the people that they mentioned, you would think that they would think that Tank Davis would be the easiest mark. I mean, you would think that. But, nah, man, I don't. Me, honestly, I don't think T.O. can beat Tank or Devin. Matter of fact, I don't think any of them can beat Tank Davis. If you really want to be honest, I think Tank Davis could beat them all. But that's neither here nor there because we're not going to see the fight. But see, what I want is people to just put Bob Arum under the microscope. I mean, put this guy under the microscope, man. You know, he'd be on people, you know, YouTube channels doing interviews. But, you know, these YouTube channels, they don't ever ask Bob Arum, like, you know, Bob, why? Isn't your plan, you know, what you're suggesting, isn't that bad for boxing? And, you know, they need to tell Bob to cut the PG-13 channel, cut the But yeah, ain't nobody going to do that. Ain't nobody going to actually tell Bob to his face to cut the you PG-13. Ain't nobody going to do that. They're not going to do it. You know, and it's like when Bob get on these shows, it's like they're having a feel-good time. They're having a feel-good time. And they know good and well this man done blocked like a million fights. And nobody wants to ask this guy or call him out. Nobody. Nobody. It's like, I guess because Bob, you know, 90-something, you know, I guess Bob can get a pass because he an old-ass man. You know, I mean, that's what I'm thinking. You know, Bob Arum is an old-ass man, so he can get a pass. And, you know, man, this dude need to be called out, man. All of them do. Eddie Hearn, anybody who block a fight, anybody under God's hot sun who block a fight, they need to be called out. They need to be called out for their BS. They need to be called out for it. Because, when this fight got proposed and, you know, and at first Teofimo Lopez was pretty excited about it. You know, and me personally, I don't even think Teofimo Lopez is afraid. I don't think he's scared. I mean, you know, a guy that's been fighting, you know, most of his life is afraid to fight somebody else. That's stupid. But I do think that T.O., I think that what he's doing is he's doing what he's seen. Now, what do I mean by that? Teofimo Lopez is doing exactly what he's seen, you know, all the greats ahead of him do in his era. You know, he watched Floyd Mayweather for years. You know, price gouged the fans. You know, he watched people like Shane Mosley do it. You know, he watched all of these people. He watched the Klitschko's do it. So, you know, he's had a good example. He's had a real good example, and he's doing exactly what those guys did in order to make the most money. That's it. Okay, when people say, well, Teofimo, he's scared of Devin. Nah, he ain't scared of Devin, ain't he? He ain't scared of him. I mean, I don't think T.O. could beat him. Oh, man, I'm allergic to ducking. Man, y'all heard that? But, no, nah, seriously, I don't think T.O.'s afraid of him. I just think, you know, Bob Arum just probably, he can't beat him. Nope, can't beat him. Can't beat him, and I'm cool with that. You can't beat him. You can't beat him, you can't beat him. But, you know, we would like to see. At least, you know, let us see the fight so we can, you know, determine for our damn selves. Okay, I mean, can Teofimo Lopez actually defeat Devin Haney or Tank Davis? But, you know, it seems like we'll never know. We'll never know. You know, it's just, it's one thing after another with Bob Arum, man. It's one thing after another, man. You know, yeah, you can say some of these other, you know, promotional companies, man, they do the same thing. But, you know, this is becoming almost as big as the Wilder Joshua situation when Eddie Hearn was, you know, keeping Anthony Joshua away from Deontay Wilder. And, you know, of course, UK fans are running around here talking about, well, you know, Wilder ain't done nothing to earn the AJ fight, but then they can't explain Carlos Takam. You know, they can never explain that. But they'll sit and tell you that Wilder don't deserve a shot at AJ. Like, stupid stuff, man. It is what it is, man. It is what it is. Hey, well, folks, I tell you this, though. I tell you this, okay? I've heard a lot of people. I'm talking about fans. And, you know, as I look across YouTube, and as I look at, you know, live streams and I look at video, I'm not a person. I'm not a, you know, like number counting people stuff. But I noticed that the boxing viewership has gone down. People who talk about boxing is going down. And you know for a fact that if viewership is going down on YouTube, I guarantee you that's going to translate to stuff like pay-per-views and, you know, free TV. It's going to translate into that because people are pretty much tired, man. People really want to see the good fights. People want to see the best. But we can't. We can't get those fights because they're being blocked. They're being held up. And I'm telling y'all, man, if boxing don't cut this out, okay, people like Bob Arum, all these other promoters, if they don't cut this stuff out, man, we're not going to have much of a sport left. We're not. We're not going to have much of a sport left. And I'm going to tell you, man, it's like, I tell you this, you know, it's crazy. It's crazy to think, man, that, you know, I mean, just the future without really boxing. But the hardcore fans are going to take off. And that means that what boxing is going to have to do is they're going to have to rely on the casual fans to keep the sport up and running, which that's not going to work because, you know, the sport don't work without hardcore fans. It don't work. It's not designed like that. The hardcore fans, whether you like a channel or you love a channel, the hardcore fans are going to keep boxing relevant because hardcore fans are going to have the motivation to go and actually talk about these fighters, you know, actually discuss their careers and have debates and whatnot. Hardcore fans are going to do that. Casual fans don't care. They're not going to do that. Okay? They won't do that. It is what it is. It is what it is. I tell you what, though, guys. Oh, my goodness gracious. What happens next, y'all? What happens next? I'm very pessimistic on whether or not we will see this fight within 2021. I'm extremely pessimistic, and I have a good reason to be.